they've seen my name, you know, or they'll come by and see my open house. But, you know, as a professional, you know, you go in and see the house and you leave the house and let the agent do their work. So that's just something that I know as times get leaner and people get more and more aggressive, trust me, they're not going to be staying in my house long, okay? So I just want you to be able to say, you know, and sometimes it's hard. If you're in front of customers, you can't say something. That's important to respect your fellow realtors. We're all doing this hard job, and I just wanted to mention that. That's my experience.
Okay, I've got 10:05, and we'll run this, you know, a little bit over as long as you want to, but we're not going to hold anybody hostage. So if you find this an interesting dialogue and you still have more questions, if our panelists, you know, have a minute or two that they're willing to share, then we'll do this. But we want this, this is for you, not for us. What do you think, Grandma? You okay with that? Rod? There, George, got 2 minutes? All right, so anybody that needs to leave, well, we understand, but anybody that has a question, we'll take it.
One question is for the panel. A lot of my transactions are short sales and I represent the seller. On a number of occasions, well, as everybody knows, the listing agent does the bulk of the work as far as negotiating and setting things up, getting things organized and coordinated with all of the other parties involved. My question is, since the listing agent is doing the bulk of the work, shouldn't he or she, or would it be appropriate if he or she had the largest percentage of the commission?
The broker, okay, you're the listing agent, I'm the selling agent. Okay. I think my broker would be a little upset if I gave away commission to the listing agent. Okay. In every contract, sometimes you're going to do more of the work and less of the work. We figure that the short sale agents understand what it's going to take to get this process through. Okay. Here again, the selling agent can be sitting there for 6 to 9 months with their client and they're trying to keep them online. That's a little difficult to deal with where you sell. I deserve more commission because I'm doing more of the work. In the next round, I'll do more of the work and you'll do less of the work in the long run.
I don't agree with that. You need my buyer in order for your sale to go through, and really that's the end of the discussion. I think this business is this business is based upon relationships. I know that you've done that to me.
Thank you, Jack. Okay.
Carol.
Oh, we wouldn't deny Carol. Not at all. Ever.
You have to be awful brave.
I think one point everybody misses in this, we're sitting here talking about buyers' agents not getting responses and buyers' listing agents not returning calls. I think the first thing we all have to do, including myself, is read the listing. Read the instructions on the listing. Because many times those listings will say, oh, we can, and some of the Freddie stuff, they have a first look on those properties, and during the first look time frame, which would be 15 to 30 days, they don't look at any investor offers, as an example. And they look at all the buyer offers at the same time. There's certain things you have to do, and if you haven't followed the instructions, you don't have a lot of room to do complaining in many cases. And as far as personal set down, present your offers, great. If you have the time and you can do that, I think it's a wonderful thing to do. However, in today's world, a lot of my business is not people that I've ever met or ever will meet, and I'm using the internet more and more to upload offers and send things across the country or around the world, and that's the world we're in. So, you know, you have to read the instructions, follow the guidelines, and a lot of those problems will go away. And if you're selling a lot of property and you're out for sure, it doesn't take you very long to figure out who's not going to be returning those calls. Right? You don't have to be real smart. Pretty soon you figure out, well, I don't want to hang around for a week for this guy and meet other buyers. If this is the property you want, you can expect to have delays and problems. And in many cases, they don't look at those offers until they get 15 together. The MLS rules may say that you have to present the offer for 24 hours. Or whatever the timelines are, but it's the investor that's calling the shots on that. And if that bank says, upload them all to me at one time and I want them by 10 o'clock on Thursday, whatever the date is, that's what you're doing, because you're following the instructions of your principal, the one who calls the shots. Okay? And they may be subject to California law, they may not be, they may be out of state.
Thank you for that good insight. Okay, we're going to call it on time now, so we're going to wrap this up in the next 2 to 3 minutes. I just want to make a couple quick announcements, and we're going to draw for some pertinent materials. In an effort to further educate our members, network, and embrace one another, on September 21st, at this